Ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and Droids, put your hands together because it's the galaxy's favorite show, Whale or Fail, with your host, the Grand Admiral, director of the video gaming division here at the Gungan Empire! How we do it?
Tell them what they can expect in this video today.
In today's video, Arnold sniffs a pack, blows his mind away with how much is needed for Relic 8. And be sure to like this video today, because if you do, Arnold's got the 8-star character giveaway for you.
What's this? You smell that?
I smell whale food.
I don't care if you're a free-to-play player or a whale or a kraken or a crate dragon. This video is going to be important because we are going to be taking a look at the new addition to our Galaxy of Heroes economy, which involves these new Relic 8 pieces. How much is it going to cost you crystal-wise free-to-play with your energy? How much is it going to cost for all our whales out there? And the numbers are going to surprise you how difficult it is to form these together. And of course, people have been asking, what are the first best Relic 8s to upgrade? We'll talk about that in a separate video. This video is all about the economy impact with these new Relic 8 pieces. Now, before we start talking about should you whale on this pack, is this pack worth it? Let's take a look at where can you get these pieces right here, one of which you can't get anywhere except the brand new Rancor Raid. And we made second place all thanks to the Jawas. Me and Anyman, the reason why we have such an advantage over the rest is because we had Jawas. Car in the top right-hand corner. Looks like Jawas is going to be one of the best teams for the Rancor Raid. But Relic 8, one of the pieces right here, these Aero Magnifiers, can only be obtained here inside of the Rancor Challenge tier raid. And as you see, man, the spread is not looking good here. So that's where the Aero Magnifiers are coming from. Super exclusive, a bit controversial right now, especially because guilds, not everyone can even do the Challenge tier Rancor raid. This is gated behind extremely endgame content. Yeah, but let's talk about these right here. These little impulse detectors. Ooh, Where do you farm those? Well, those can be farmed both free-to-play and pay to play. And the only way to do it as of now, besides this pack, is by going to your local Jawa scavenger and scrolling all the way down to these impulse detectors. And basically, you're gonna be scrapping the gear 12 piece on the left-hand side that the Electrum conductors do not need. Now, PSA, if you're someone that faints really easily at surprising things, you might want to skip this part because it's insane how steep Relic 8 is. Let's take a look at Los Pollos Imperiales, Moff Gideon. Not really helpful in the Rancor raids, by the way. You can't apply Demoralize, you can't control Terminator, so he's like, not really too helpful. How much do you need to get to Relic 8? And here we go, we see it right here. You need 20 Electrum conductors, 20 Zimbital cards, you need 20 impulse detectors, and 20 Aero Magnifiers. Now on the surface, it's like, all right, it's just 20, that's not too bad. Hold on, Chief. Let me show you how much is needed to get this going. Here are our impulse detectors here. Take a little guess, let's play a little game. How many gear 12 pieces do you think we need to get 20 of these impulse detectors? Go on, write your comment down below. Leave a little comment. While you're at it, drop a like on this video if this is your favorite show. All right, did your answer say 184? And that is what it's gonna take to get 20 of these impulse detectors, which aren't even included in the raid gear watch. We're gonna burn it all away. I'm not gonna actually burn it, but let me just show you. Here we go. We only have 8 of them. Look at that, we're only at 17, and look at this. And let's put the cherry on top. Oh, we're not quite there yet. Let's just go ahead, sprinkle a few more. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, yeah. And there we go. So to get 20 impulse detectors, you're gonna need to be scrapping how many? Hey Siri, what's 76 plus 81 plus 27?
That would be 184.
To take a deeper dive in this Relic 8, it's time to pull up our handy dandy whale or fail spreadsheet. Link down below in the video description in case you missed the last whale or fail video. It was kind of super late at night. I have compiled an extensive guide on the free to play cost of relics, mods, gear, as well as the pay to play cost. And this spreadsheet will also have a separate independent tab looking at the pack review analysis. But if you scroll all the way down on the list in the blue section, you're gonna come across our Relic economy analysis here. We'll kind of walk through the spreadsheet so you have a better understanding of how to use this reference. So as you see right down below here, we have our two Relic 8 pieces added. We have the impulse detectors and the Aero Magnifiers. But the most important thing is how many crystals does it cost to get a singular piece of the new Relic 8 materials? And we're gonna kind of run into a problem because you can't quite whale or farm the arrow magnifiers, as we're gonna see. But in regards to the impulse detectors, to farm a single piece of the impulse detectors, we're looking at 275 crystals. If you're a pay-to-play player that primarily likes to buy the gear out of the shipments to scrap away. And here's where the free-to-play analysis comes in. If you're a free-to-play player that farms your gear via crystal energy refreshes, you're looking at about 230 crystals per single piece of the impulse detectors. So let's talk about how did we come up with the math? Because again, you can't directly buy this stuff anywhere. Well, as we saw, it's geared 12 pieces. You gotta scrap away to turn into this stuff. So let's show you how the math works. If you scroll up in the red section, we have literally all of the gear that's in Galaxy of Heroes. And we again show the energy crystal cost as well as the pay-to-play shipment crystal cost to come up with the analysis. And the energy refresh analysis takes the assumption you're getting the average drop rate of about 30% or so. You might get more, you might get less. We have to take the average. We got to work with something here. And here are the numbers we're working with. These are the gear 12 pieces. And as you see, traditionally in the shipments, they cost 30 crystals a piece. And if you're farming them free-to-play, they cost about 25 crystals per gear 12 piece. And from there, it's basic math. As I showed you when we were inside the scavenger, where we're showing how many pieces it takes to get a single impulse detector, we showed you need at least 10 to get the first one. But really, mathematically, we're looking at about 9.166 gear 12 pieces to get you one impulse detector. So really, all we're doing to get that pay-to-play number of 275 is we're doing 30 times 9.1666, and we're rounding up the number, which gets us 275. And if you're free-to-play, farming those gear 12 pieces free-to-play costs about 25 crystals each with your crystal energy refreshes. And then when you do 25 times 9.166666, round it up, you're getting 230. And unfortunately, the arrow magnifiers, there is no way to quantify in this economy how much an arrow magnifier is worth. We put an unknown in there. For you, you might value it extremely high depending on what type of player you are. So really, the arrow magnifiers, it's going to be a personal evaluation. And in this pack review that we're going to do, if you want to see the pack reviews, be sure to click on the second tab, which brings up my in-depth pack reviews on all of the packs we've seen in game the past while now. And we're gonna scroll all the way down, baby, to find this Relic Challenge pack. And with that conversation of how the heck do you quantify or give a value to the Relic 8 Aero Magnifiers, we're actually gonna kind of analyze this pack and assume there is no Relic 8 in there. And the numbers I give you are the numbers without that value, and you can add whatever you want on top. If you value it 10,000 crystals per 10 pieces of arrow magnifiers, go for it. So looking at the pack, here's all the stuff listed here. And really, the most important things in here are the Electrum conductors, the Zimbital cards, the Relic 8 impulse detectors, and the Relic 8 arrow magnifiers that are in this pack. And exclusive are those Relic 8 arrow magnifiers. This is definitely one of the more generous packs when it comes to Zimbital cards. They're giving 20 Zimbital cards. Take a look at the more pay-to-play approach, the shipment analysis. If you want to total everything up in this pack, in total, we're looking at about 13,250 crystals in value. We'll look at it pragmatically in a second, but looking at the free-to-play analysis, which is more focused on the energy refresh cost, you're getting about 9,644 crystals in value. So if you're a whale, you buy out of shipments, this pack, taking everything at face value, you're getting about $104 to $85 of value. And the energy farm analysis means that we're getting somewhere between $76 and $62 in value in this pack. So is it a whale or is it a fail, ladies and gentlemen? You might be seeing that green. We're gonna give this pack a whale for both the pay-to-play shipment analysis as well as the energy refresh cost analysis. However, let's look at this pragmatically for a second. Yes, the total picture, it's looking nice and pretty. We got a lot of Zimbital cards. You know what makes Papa happy? If you're a whale, this pack is a no-brainer. This is the whale food right here. So this is an obvious whale. But if you're someone that only cares about a few things in the pack, as I note here, this pack will be a break-even or possibly a fail if you don't care about the other Relic pieces, or if you don't even care about Relic 8. Because if you start deducting the credits and you start deducting the signal data that you really could farm easily of Cantina Energy, and you don't care about the bronze M wiring or the carbonite circuit boards or the iridium heat sinks, and you're only looking at the Electrum conductors and the Zimbital cards, you're not really going to get that much of a deal. But this pack is all about the Relic 8 stuff. And of course, we included a crystal estimation for the Relic 8 impulse detectors, but we didn't give any value whatsoever to the Relic 8 Aero Magnifiers because I can't quite put a value on it just yet as of now. But really, if you care about Electrum Conductors, you care about Zimbital cards, and you care about the new Relic 8 stuff, this pack is definitely going to be a whale. But hold on! A few PSAs before you go out and buy this pack, depending on your intentions. If you're buying this pack hoping it's enough to get you to Relic 8, the answer is yes and no. Buying this pack once? No. This pack, buying it once, will not take a character to Relic 8 because, again, you need 20 of both of these pieces and you're only getting 10. So if you want to take a single character to Relic 8, you got to spend $100. And there's a possibility, some of you major Krakens and whales out there, you could possibly get two Relic 8 characters because you buy this pack twice. That gets you a Relic 8. If you're someone that already finished one or two in the challenge tier rank raid, well, you either got 10 or 11 Aero Magnifiers. And at that point, you're going to have about 30 Aero Magnifiers. And if you buy this pack for the third time, purchase limit of 3, it gets you just enough to get 40 Aero Magnifiers. And then you're just going to have to get 10 more pieces of the Impulse Detectors. And boom, shakalaka. You're gonna get two Relic 8 characters. Unlike the last whaler fail, we are gonna whale on this pack, and I will buy two of them. Again, even if this didn't have the Relic 8 stuff, the Zimbital cards and the Electrum Conductors, man, those are a pain in the butt to get. This is gonna help out, and the bank says it's a whale. We'll buy it one more time as well. So that way, when we do our what characters to Relic 8 first, I have some stuff to kind of show what I'm gonna Relic 8 first. I have a couple of ideas in mind here. Definitely Galactic Legends. If you're a Galactic Legends owner, you probably want to give a Relic 8 to him, but there are some other non-Galactic Legends characters I got my eyes peeled for. And one more time, one for the money, two for the whales, three for the dolphins, and go, go, go! The bank says it's a whale. Give him a round of applause, baby. Woo! Man, this Relic 8 stuff, I really, really hope. We're going to talk about this again in a whole other video. Although I do like the rank core, I think it's a good challenge. The problem is, I think people are having, is that how are you going to get this new Relic 8 Aero Magnifiers? If you're someone that's a mid-game player, you're like in that 4 or 5 million GP range, which makes you a decent player in the game, but it's going to be very difficult to compete with that inside the challenge tier rank raid and clear it with a guild that's similar like you. And that's going to wrap it up for today, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, for every person that likes this video today, you'll be getting, for free, an 8-star Ben Swallow!
This is not a scam.
As always, thank you guys so much for watching. It's an absolute pleasure talking about this stuff. Let me know your thoughts down below about Relic 8, the rank core raids. We're going to talk a lot more about what characters the Relic 8 and my opinion on this rank raid now that we completed it. And most importantly, always remember, it's great to be in the Empire today.